Welcome to my YouTube channel on Engineer Mechanics with illustrations. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates. Okay, so let us move on to the next problem. So the other problem, it goes like this. Okay, we have another problem where it is similar to the previous problem, but here the bodies are resting on an inclined plane with an angle theta, okay, and so the block, 300 Newton block, is connected to a wall like this, okay. So now what we should do is, they have asked, okay, what should be the value of theta in figure 2 which will make the motion motion of 900 Newton block down the plane to impend. The coefficient of friction for all the contact surfaces is so coefficient of friction for all the contact surfaces is given by 1/3, so that's nothing but 0.333. okay, so these are the values, given values. Okay, so what we should find is actually the value of theta. We are supposed to find the value of theta. Okay, so this value of theta, which is over here. Now let us consider the problem. So as we know, because there is no force acting on it, because the self weight itself is sufficient to slide the body downward. So if you click next, so in this video you can see this is the block. Okay, as the 900 kilo newton block is heavy, it slide downwards, and as you know, there will be the friction force acting upwards like this at both the surfaces, and relatively the 300 newton block will go up. It will be moving upwards. It's a relative motion. Okay, that's not, it won't move, be moving. So with respect to 900 newton, it the relative motion of that 300 newton will be upwards. So therefore the frictional force will be happening downwards. Okay, so that's how the forces will act during the sliding of this 900 newton downwards. Okay, so let me just, so now let us move on to the next thing. What we need to do, we need to draw the free body diagram separately. Okay, consider equilibrium of 300 newton block. As you know, because when you consider this block, so this is the angle theta, and this angle, if you draw a perpendicular, so if I draw a perpendicular like this over here, okay, so this will be 90 minus theta. Okay, so this angle will be 90 minus theta. And now you can if you draw a horizontal, you will have a weight acting downwards like this. If you draw a horizontal over here, okay, and because these two will be opposite angles, okay, so you will get that this is equal to 90 minus theta. This is 90 minus theta. Okay, this will be 90 degree. Okay, this will be 90 degree, and this is 90 minus theta. And if you draw a line like this, okay, so these are the two alternative angles. Okay, this and this will be two alternative angles, and that angle will become 90 minus theta over here. Okay, so this will be 90 minus theta, since this will be theta. Okay, and by considering this one, let us apply equations of equilibrium. So if you apply sigma, Fy is equal to 0, so that's nothing but N1 minus 300, that sine 90 minus theta, because it will be acting downwards, vertical component. and horizontal component. What we will be doing here is we are considering not x and y, we are considering a normal plane. Okay, so this is tangential direction and this will be normal direction. Okay, so n1 minus 300 sine 90 minus theta, okay, that's equal to 0. Therefore, you will get the value of n1 equal to 300 sine 90 minus theta. Next, we have another, that's what it will be. It can be written as n1 minus 300 cos theta, which is equal to n1 is equal to 300 cos theta. So we know the coefficient of friction is equal to 0.1 by 3. Therefore, f1 by n1 is equal to 0.1 by 3, or f1 is equal to 1 by 3 n1. So 100 cos theta it will become. Okay. So the value of f1. Next, consider 900 Newton block. So you can see here. So you can see a 900 Newton block here, okay, which is So which you can see here, consider 900 Newton block. You can consider. So here you can see. If you apply sigma fy is equal to 0, n2 minus n1, and these n1 will have equal and opposite forces. As I was telling like this in here in this problem. So this vertical force and these vertical force will be equal and opposite because this is the same contact surface. Okay, they will get cancelled out to each and one. Each one of them when they are together, but when you separate them, this is separate and this is separate. Okay, just like that. So therefore, n2 minus n1 minus 900 Newton is equal to 0. So n2 is equal to n1 plus 900 cos 0. Okay, so see, this is like previous case. So because this one will be actually equal to 900 sin 90 minus theta, same angle will be there here. Okay. And therefore, n2 minus n1 minus 900 cos theta. Sine 90 minus theta will be cos theta. Therefore, n2 is equal to n1 cos theta and n2 will be equal to 1200 cos theta. Okay. So that will be the final value. This is the n2 value, 1200 cos theta. And also, we have from the principle, so f1 by f2 by n2 is equal to 1200 cos theta. Therefore, you can just say into mu, that's nothing but 1 by 3 if you multiply. So that will become 400 cos theta it will become. Next, if you consider sigma f x equal to 0 or f, it's not f x equal to 0, f tangential, okay? So this is parallel to the plane, okay? So if you consider summation of all the forces parallel to the plane, so then it will be f1. So because the F1 will be acting towards right, therefore positive F1 plus F2. F2 is also acting parallel to the plane, towards the right, minus F2 sine theta. Sine theta is nothing but cos 90 minus theta. This is actually cos 90 minus theta. So that becomes sine theta, okay? Cos 90 minus theta. Because you can see that's the horizontal component which is acting towards the left. That's the reason why it is minus. So 900 cos 90 minus theta, which becomes sine theta. Okay. So upon simplification, you are substituting F1 and F2 and then simplifying, you will get the value of tan theta is equal to 500 by 900 and theta is equal to 29.05 degree. Now let me continue. This is the problem. Let us take another problem. See, all of you read the problem. What is the value of P in the system shown in the figure 3 to cause the motion to impend? Okay, that is nothing but just start moving motion. Okay, assume the pulley is smooth and the coefficient of friction between the other contact surfaces is 0.2. Okay, so as you can see in this figure, this is the pulley. Okay. which is fixed over here, and there is a force P which is being applied at an angle of 30 degree. So when you pull it, what actually happens? Anybody?
It slides up, sir. The 750
Newton. Yeah, the 750 Newton will slide up, and 500 Newton will slide towards the right, isn't it? That right, is what. And what will be the direction of the forces? Friction force, normal reaction, another thing.
For 500 Newton, will be diagonally block, down.
Yeah, the 500 force Newton. Will be, yeah, let me just animate that. So if you apply a pulling force like this, so what actually happens? You can very clearly you can see as you pull the block 500 Newton block towards the right. So it moves along with that 750 Newton block will also move just like this, and therefore both the blocks will move towards right or up the plane, isn't it? Right and up the plane. Therefore, the friction force will be towards left, just like this, and here the friction force will be towards downward direction. And as usual, the normal reactions will be upwards. Just like this, upwards and upwards. Okay, so this is how you will be able to visualize the frictional force and the normal reactions. Okay, so any doubt here? Anybody? Somebody were asking. They're raising their hands. You can ask here. Hello.
No, sir.
Any doubt?
No, sir.
So this is a fixed pulley, okay? So on that it will be that string will be moving. This will be rotating, and so the blocks will be moving like this. So frictional force will be developing. So we are required to find out the value of P such a way that the blocks will slide upwards and right towards right. So that is our question. So what we need to do now? We need to draw free body diagram separately. Okay, so in addition to this, the weight of the 500 Newton block will be acting downwards like this. Okay, and here the weight of the block 750 Newton will act downwards in addition to these forces. So, and there will be what else you will be developed in the figure? There will be tension developed in the string like this, isn't it? So, there will be tension which will be developed in the string, because this 500 Newton block tries to pull. Because of the weight of the 750 Newton block, it tries to go down, but this 500 Newton block along with the force P, finally it the block will, both the blocks will be moving upwards. But whatever, there will be friction, there will be tension developed in the string. Okay, so let us draw the free body diagram separately. Okay, that is what I've explained. So if you draw the free body diagram, as I've already explained, there will be 700 weight acting downwards, as you can see here, and there will be tension developed in the string which will be there like this. Okay, and as usual, let us consider this friction force as F1. Okay, for 750 Newton, and this force will be N1. Okay, this normal reaction, whereas here let this be F2. And this be N2, okay, the normal reaction, sir. And now, which block will you consider first for solving the problem? Anybody? Will it be 750 Newton or will it be 500 Newton? Which one to be considered first, so that we can solve the
750.
Why is that so?
Less number of forces.
Who is this talking?
Anirudh.
Aniruddha. Yeah, good. Okay, good. So here, as you can see, there is one unknown, which is tension, and F1 is another unknown. If you know mu value, you can calculate either F1 or N1. Okay, so these together will be a one unknown if you know the value of mu. Since in this problem, the value of mu is given equal to 0.2, so both the F1 and N1 together will become one unknown. So this is one unknown. And second unknown, so hence, and also this is a concurrent force system or non-concurrent force system? Which one will be
non-concurrent? Non-concurrent.
Yeah, if you consider both the force, both the bodies, it will be non-concurrent. But if you consider only this 750 Newton block, it will be concurrent, because Actually, you can, as I've already told you, this size effect in engine mechanics is neglected. We cannot consider the size as if we need to assume that these forces are acting over here. Understood? And this F2 will be acting over here. Okay. And hence it is a concurrent force system as we were considering all the time, isn't it? So similarly, another block will be there, which is nothing but 500 Newton block. After you find out F1 and N1 and T, so just to substitute the value of T here, then the unknowns will become 1 and 2. And we know from equations of equilibrium of concurrent forces, we can solve two unknowns at any cost. You can do it by the way, okay? So that's how you need to do it. Let us now consider equilibrium of this, 750 Newton. So if, and in this kind of inclined body problems, we usually, what we do, we will not consider sigma fx equal to 0 and sigma fy is equal to 0. Instead, what we do? Sigma?
Tangential and normal.
Sigma component. N equal to 0 or sigma fn equal to 0 and sigma ft equal to 0. That we will consider, isn't it? So that is what we will be doing here. Now, if you consider sigma normal, okay? If you consider sigma normal forces, what are the forces which will be there? So since this 750 Newton will be there, and we will be resolving that into two components, one over here and other one will be the horizontal, the force which will be there in the tangential direction. Now, if you consider normal direction, so what are the forces? N1, which will act upwards, minus 750 cos 60. Cos 60, why? Because that, you know, this angle will be 90 minus 60. Therefore, this will become 750 sine 60 minus, 90 minus theta, which will become cos theta, 750 cos theta, isn't it? So, this will become 750 cos 60, and that will be acting downwards. So, therefore, you will get the value of N1 equal to 375 Newton. Next, we know from the friction equation, F1 by N1 is equal to mu. Therefore, F1 is equal to mu times N1. And you can find out the value of F1. So that is necessary in case of sigma Ft is equal to 0. Now consider sigma F of T equal to 0. So in which, what are the forces you have? T minus F1, because that is acting towards...
That should be 750 sine 60.
Which one? Yeah, that is what I'm telling you. So sine 60 is nothing but, actually speaking, that is nothing but cos 90 minus theta, okay? Because we will be considering always with respect to the tangential or the horizontal direction, right? Angle with respect to horizontal. Angle with respect to horizontal is 90 minus 60 or 90 minus theta.
That's okay? Given 60, sir.
Yeah, 90 minus 60, because that's nothing but 30 degree, which is nothing but cos 30 or sine 60, one and the same. Understood? Yes, any sir. Doubt, anybody?
But sir, the angle is 60 degree with the tangential component.
Yeah, let me just clear you people. Okay. So here, if we do is, we will consider.
We have this
angle, okay, 60 degree, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, let me just go back to the previous slide. So we have been given with this angle 30 degree. Okay, if this is, and we know that this is 60 degree. If this is 60, how do you represent here? You can draw a line here. Okay, so and you will have, let me draw. If this is 60, we know that the weight will be acting downwards, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Just like this. Okay. What will be this angle?
30.
Isn't it 30 degree? And with respect to vertical, it will be
60 degree.
60 degree, isn't it? 60 degree and 30 degree. So R, what instead of 30, what you do, you consider it as 90 minus 60. Okay. One and the same, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Can't you consider that?
Yes, sir.
90 minus 60. So if you agree with that, let us move on to the next slide here. So as you know, this angle is 90 minus 60. Okay, so this angle is 90 minus 60. Now you resolve. So what will be sigma ft? Sigma ft, if you consider, sigma ft is equal to, what are the forces which you'll have? So one is T.
Tension.
Okay, T, that goes towards right, positive, minus F1, next minus
750 sine 60.
Sin cos 60. 90 minus theta, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
750 cos 90 minus 60. Okay, 90 minus 60. So, what will be that result in T minus F, T minus F1 minus 750 sin 60, isn't it? So, cos 90 yes, minus theta will be cos sin theta. All of you agree, right?
Yes.
That is why. So, this will become sin 60, 750 sin 60 instead of cos 90, cos 30 is equal to sin 60, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, that is all. Okay.
Got it, sir.
Yeah, got it. So, that's how you will get the value of T equal to, finally equal to 724. Okay. That is a free body diagram of figure 1. Okay. Next block, the 750 Newton block. Next, move on to the 500 Newton block. So, we know from the previous, figure that, from previous figure, 724.5 is the tension. Okay. This is 724 point something. So, this is known now. Okay. If you know this value of T, so P and F2 and N2 are only two unknowns there which you can solve easily by using equations of equilibrium. Now, consider sigma Fy is equal to 0. If you consider sigma Fy or Fe is equal to 0, N2 which goes upwards, positive, minus 500 which act downwards. Okay, plus this P component will also act upwards, P sine 30, because it is 30 degree. So, therefore, upward force will be P sine 30, which is equal to 0. Plus, therefore, N2 plus 0.5 P is equal to 500. This is one equation. Just keep it like that. And next, from loss of friction, F2 is equal to mu times N2. So, by that, you will get the value of F2, 100 minus 0.1 P. And then consider sigma FH equal to 0. Because it is a horizontal body, the body resting on a horizontal figure, you can take sigma Fy and sigma Fx equal to 0 or sigma FH equal to 0. Therefore, P cos 30, that is acting towards right, okay? And then minus T, that acts towards left. You can see here, minus T. And minus F2, that's also because that is acting towards the left. Therefore, simplifying that, you will get the value of P is equal to 853.5 Newton. Thank you for watching. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates.